वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आवर सेशन ऑफ फिनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट. एज फार एज आर प्रीवियस सेशन वॉज कंसर्न, इन दैट वी डिस्कस अबाउट द म्यूचुअल फंड कंपनीज, हाउ म्यूचुअल फंड कंपनीज आर गोइंग टू इन्वेस्ट इन द कैपिटल मार्केट ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ इन्वेस्टर्स. देन आफ्टर वी हैव सीन अबाउट factoring institutions, that how these institutions are going to purchase the book debts of the seller and provide sufficient money to them, and then after they are going to bridge the short-term shortage of the cash flow. Today we are going to discuss about credit evaluation institutions, or we can say that credit rating institutions. Now first and foremostly we are going to discuss about what is credit rating agencies and how they are working. Actually credit rating agencies are going to work to rate the organization's credit worthiness. When any organization want to raise borrowed capital in the market, when they are going to raise the debt capital in the market, now at that point of time these type of credit rating agencies are going to evaluate the financial strength of the organization on the basis of their past performance, how the organization is effective, and again they are going to see that in a near future is the company is able to repay the borrowed capital with timely payment of interest rate. So here, before raising the borrowed capital in the market, the organization, they are going to approach the credit rating agencies that please evaluate ourselves, please evaluate the financial position of our organization, and on the basis of that evaluation give us a proper credit range. Then after, on the basis of this credit rates or credit rank, there are few investors, or we can say that there are many investors who are going to evaluate the rates which is given by the credit rating agencies, and on the basis of that rank they are taking the decision that whether to invest in a particular organization or not. So credit rating agencies, these companies are going to have the evaluation of credit worthiness of the organization who wishes to raise borrowed capital in the market. Make my words, it is basically for the borrowed capital. And why the credit rating is required? The main reason is that if you are raising the equity, then there is a no question of payment of dividend, then there is a no question of repayment of the capital amount. But as far as the borrowed capital are concerned, in the borrowed capitals it is highly required for the organization to make the repayment of the principal amount along with the payment of interest rate on them. So for raising the debt capital, the evaluation of credit worthiness is required. Now let's see about the introduction part. A credit rating agency, also called a rating service, is a company that assigns credit ratings which rate a debtor's ability to pay back debt by making timely principal and interest payment and the likelihood of default. An agency may rate the creditworthiness of issuers of debt obligations, of debt instruments, and in some cases of the services of the underlying debts, but not of individual consumers. Now, this is a generalized evaluation of creditworthiness. Here, the agency is not going to target to rate some organization for any individual customer, but this rate is totally generalized, and after assigning a credit rates to that particular company, credit rating agency are going to publish the rank or the rates in the stock market, and that is openly. So each and every investors, each and every financial institutions comes to know about how the creditworthiness of the particular organization is and whether to invest or not, that is totally depends upon the investor's preference. The debt instruments rated by credit rating agencies include government bonds, corporate bonds, certificate of deposits, municipal bonds, preferred stock, and collateralized securities, such as mortgage-backed securities and collateralized debt obligations. A credit rating is a quantified assessment of the creditworthiness of a borrower in a general terms or with respect to a particular debt or financial obligations. A credit rating can be assigned to any entity that seeks to borrow money, means it is for an individual, a corporations, states or provisional authorities or sovereign government. So these rates are in a general terms. Credit rating agency are not going to target some particular group of investors that the rate is for them only, but it is totally generalized form. Now there are few well-known institutions of credit rating agency who are going to work for checking the creditworthiness of particular corporation. The first one is CRISIL. CRISIL is Credit Rating Information and Services of India Limited. The second one is ICRA. ICRA stands for Investment Information and Credit Rating Agency of India. And third one, CARE. Credit Rating Credit Analysis and Research Limited. And they are going to give rank from AAA to D. There are ranks that we are going to discuss. The first rank is AAA. So when credit rating agency give AAA to some organization, it means the investment is totally secure and the repayment of principal and interest rate is totally secured by the agencies. So the risk perception is very low. So as far as AAA, AA and A is concerned, our investment is highly secured. Then after it is come about BBB. BBB, BB and B. So this stands for moderate risk. That if you are investing in that particular organization, then there is not 100% surety that you are getting your principal back. But somehow your investment is secured up to 50%. So that stands for moderate risk. And then comes after C and D. For C and D, the level of risk is very high. So there is a no surety of repayment of the principal amount and the interest amount. And basically D stands for default. So credit rating agency says that it is not advisable to invest in this particular organization. So it's about the ranks of rating agencies. I think it is clear to each and everyone. Now let's start the new point, that is OTCEI. That stands for Over the Counter Exchange of India Limited. OTCEI, that is for those shares and securities which are not listed in any of the stock exchanges. Many a time it is possible that with the obligations of the stock exchanges, stock markets, there are few securities which are not eligible for listing in the stock market, that is in Bombay Stock Exchange and in National Stock Exchange. So over the counter exchange of India Limited, it is a place where the organization are able to sell their shares or securities which are unlisted, so they can easily get the platform for selling their unlisted stocks and securities. OTCEI was established in August 1989 under Section 25 of the Companies Act 1956. The shares or securities which are not listed in stock exchange or could not be listed. Many a times some organizations are not able to fulfill each and every requirement of the stock exchanges. So at that point of time, the shares and securities issued by them could not be listed in any of the stock exchanges. So that organization get the opportunity to sell their shares and securities in OTCEI with a formal platform of the government, that is of SEBI. UTI, then after SBI, IDBI, ICICI, IFCI, LIC and Capital Market are the primary fund investors in OTCEI. Now make one thing clear that when your stocks and securities are not listed, then that particular share is not available to the common people. It is not for the general investors. So, for the primary investors, they are going to target these institutions or the capital market who are going to purchase these unlisted shares or securities. Actually, these primary financial institutions, they have a huge level of funding and they are able to invest in crores of rupees. So definitely the company which are totally unlisted in the stock exchange gets their investors very easily. And when there is an investment from this kind of primary fund investors, they can easily maintain the transparency in the dealing with the organization. So it is really very formal and clear platform for the organization to sell their unlisted security in the market. The OTCEI has some special features that make it a unique exchange in India, as well as being a growth catalyst for small to medium sized company. The following are some of its unique features. Basically, it is very difficult for small and medium company to get their self listed in the recognized stock exchange because initial stage they do not have sufficient capital or net worth with them. So without enough capital, without enough net worth, the organizations are not able to make themselves listed. And if the listing is not there, then they are not able to raise the huge capital in the market. So OTCEI is for those company who fail to follow each and every criterias of the stock exchange. So they can easily sell their unlisted shares or securities directly through a formal platform of OTCEI. Now discuss about the unique features of it. The first one is stock restriction. Stocks that are listed on other stock exchanges will not be listed on the OTCEI, and conversely, stock listed on OTCEI will not be listed on other exchanges. It is really very beneficial for the organization to get a specific market for their shares and security. If you are failed to listed yourself in the stock exchange, then OTCEI is for you to make an investment. But if the other company whose shares and security are there in BSE or NSE, then that organizations are not able to sell their stock and security through OTCEI. The requirement for the minimum issued equity capital is 30 lakh rupees, which is approximately $40,000. So the capital requirement is really very small. The next one, large company restriction. Companies with issued equity capital of more than 25 crore rupees are not allowed to be listed in OTCEI. So OTCEI is not for the large organization. It is only for the small and medium cap companies. Then after, member base capital requirement. Here, the members of OTCEI must maintain a base capital of rupees 4 lakh to continue to be listed on the stock exchange or on the OTCEI. So here, the company who want to become the member of OTCEI, they need to maintain a primary capital of rupees 4 lakh rupees to continue to be listed on OTCEI, and that amount is totally very small one. So this is the basic categories, or we can say that it is the basic features of OTCEI. Now let's see the process, that how OTCEI sell the unlisted stocks and securities. The investor has to reach to the OTCEI counter and find out the price and take the purchase decision. Here, the investor who wishes to purchase the stocks which are listed on OTCEI, they went to the OTCEI counter and find out the prices of different shares and securities, and then after they are going to make the decision about the purchase. For the deal, the investor has to issue a check. Besides price of the machinery, the brokerage is also included in the amount of the check. Whatever shares or security the investor wishes to purchase. So at that point of time, the investor is going to give a check to him or check to OTCEI, which includes the brokerage charges in it. After the check issuing of 1 week, the check is credited and the investor gets its receipt. The investor who want to sell off securities, they have to take the following steps. So now, by issuing the check, when the check is credited, so at that point of time, the transaction of sale is completed, and in a return, the creditor gets the receipt of his check or of his purchase. Now, if an investor wishes to sell his security in OTCEI, again, investor has to submit a transfer document and he is going to obtain a receipt of the effect of the PCR has been submitted. And when his application will accepted by the OTCEI, then definitely OTCEI will issue a check of his selling price, and that check will be credited within a week of the selling transaction. So this is a normal process through which an investor is going to purchase or sell the securities of OTCEI. Now let's discuss about the advantages of OTCEI. It provides a trading platform for smaller and less liquid companies, as they are not qualified for listing on a standard exchange. I think it is clear. It is a cost-effective method for corporate, as there is a lower cost of new issues and lower expense of serving the investors. Family concern and closely held companies can go public through OTC. Dealer can operate both in new issues and secondary market at their option. Secondary market is nothing but it is a stock market. It gives greater freedom of choice to investors to choose stocks by dealers of market, making in both primary and secondary market. Then after, it is a transparent system of trading with no problem of bad or short delivery. Immediate delivery is possible in OTCEI. Information flows are free and more direct from market makers to consumer, since there is close contact between them. OTC trading is a regular practice in the energy market, representing the biggest volume of electricity market transaction in many countries. So, the main organization who takes the benefit of OTC is energy market, or the company who produce electricity. An OTC market is dissimilar than a customary exchange because it is decentralized and does not take place in one spot. OTC trade take place electronically and directly between two parties. Yes, there is no formal place of OTC, and each and every transaction goes electronically and directly between the seller and the purchaser of the investors. For both investors and companies, OTC markets are more cost efficient than customary stock exchange. Investor can buy into companies that will shape the world on a more cost efficient platform. The cost at the time of selling or at the time of purchasing the security is really very low as compared to the recognized stock exchange. The architecture of the OTC markets helps to explain why structured security faced problem during the latest economic disaster, because the market is really very wide. There are so many companies, there are so many investors. So it is very difficult to find out where to invest and how much to invest. So that is not an issue in OTC market, because the companies which are totally unlisted are limited and the investors are also few. So there is no misunderstanding between the investors and between the CEOs. So that's all about today's session, that is OTCEI market. In the next session, we are going to discuss about NSE and NSDL. Till now, it is